Hi, this is Dr. Palaniappan Manickam. I'm certified in internal medicine and gastroenterology, and I'm practicing in California. I thought I'll share some information about coronavirus and then update you based on what I know and I've seen in clinical practice. I know it doesn't sound like a typical doctor interview. You know, there is no anchor. Sometimes in those doctor interview, you'll be like, that anchor doesn't want to be there. And the doctor is so uptight with the white jacket and the stethoscope. And his main goal is to not to smile throughout the interview. So I thought I'll just make it a little bit different. Not because that nobody is there to interview me. There were people lined up to interview me. I just thought that, you know, I'll just give them some more time. Okay. But anyways, if you guys are interested to interview me, please let me know. I'll be happy to in the next video. Okay. There was nobody. All right. So just to confirm this, can you see this? Palaniappan Manickam, California physician licensed. இதுக்கு மேல ப்ரூவ் பண்ண முடியாது அண்ட் ஜஸ்ட் டு ப்ரூவ் மை கிரெடிபிலிட்டி ஓகே ஆல்ரைட் சோ ஐம் ஜஸ்ட் கோயிங் டு ரன் த்ரூ த ஃப்ரீக்வென்ட்லி ஆஸ்க் க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ் அபவுட் கொரோனா ஆல்ரைட் சோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் க்வெஸ்சன் வந்து இஸ் திஸ் கொரோனா நியூ டு அஸ் ஆக்சுவலி கொரோனா மீன்ஸ் இன் லாட்டின் இட்ஸ் அ ஹேட் அ வைரஸ் ஹேஸ் அ ஹேட் அரவுண்ட் இட் And this is not new to us. We have seen this time and again before. In 2003, it came back as SARS in Hong Kong. And then in 2012, it came back as MERS in Abu Dhabi. And now in 2020, it is coming back as COVID-19 in China. It belongs to the same family. It just comes in three different forms. It's like first virus is Shivaji Ganesan. Second virus is Prabhu. And the third virus is Vikram Prabhu. At least the first two virus know how to act. This third virus doesn't know how to act and also annoys us to the core. And that's the problem. Why is it bad now? Why is it everybody is talking about it? The main reason is the risk of community acquired infection is very high with this virus. What I mean by community acquired infection is you don't have to be around an infected person to get this virus. The virus is just spread throughout the community, and that is why people consider this as a dangerous virus because it can be easily spread. I'll give you an example. Let's say you go to the temple, you give $100 to the god, and then pray that Muruga enakku corona varama paathuka abindu. Little do you know, the priest who is standing right next to you has been infected with corona already, even though he has not left the temple for the last 10 years. He comes with a laddu and give it as a free prasad to you. Just before giving it to you, he makes a big sneeze right into that laddu. And you are so excited on seeing the laddu. And just the sight of the appetizing laddu, you put your hand on it and just put it into your mouth. And boom, the corona is inside your body. And you don't leave it right there. You also have your son get it. Sami, tambi ko unu kuduthirunga. Free a kudutha, rendu laddu kuda vaangonaanga. That's how it is getting spread even without you knowing. So that is why this is so being talked about in the news. Does this mean that are we going to die? If Vikram Prabhu continues to act in the movies, we will definitely die. But not related to corona. Maybe corona we might escape. I'll give you some numbers. So if let's say we take 100 patients with coronavirus. 83 patients do very well. So they don't have any problems at all. They'll have like mild fever, sore throat, cough, will be sick for like 2 to 3 days and they recover completely. They will not have any problems at all. It is those remaining 17 patients where there could be some problems. Out of that 17 patients, 15 patients might go on to develop complications. For example, what I mean by complication is if the virus stays more than 3 days, it starts eating up your lung cavities and then starts having pneumonia. So you will start having like high fever, shortness of breath. You can't breathe that much to a point that you might need hospital admission. So it's similar to like being with your in-laws family. You know, if your in-laws family is in your with you for 3 days, you know what? That's okay. You could survive. But if they are for 3 months, you will feel like you better get corona and be quarantined. It is exactly similar to that. Within 3 days, the mild infection will go away. If it stays beyond 3 days, it will end up in complication. The most important category of patients is those 2% of patients where this virus can actually cause severe illness to a point that we might not be able to save them. Again, this 2% does not belong to healthy population. There is certain high risk features associated with this virus, with this 2% people. For example, patients should be patients who are 80 years old, patients who are elderly and a male, and if they have other medical problems like diabetes, hypertension, liver disease, anything like that, then they are at an increased risk. In a nutshell, think about Amitabh Bachchan. If you have a guy like Amitabh Bachchan who's 80 years old, who's male, who has other medical problems, you have to make sure that he doesn't get coronavirus infection at all. You do all the preventive measures possible, because those patients will go down south pretty soon. Okay. All right. So how do we prevent this? There are two ways to spread this virus. One is your loud friend comes right in front of you and then coughs right on your face. You get all the secretions into your body and boom, you get the coronavirus. Second is you touch all the infected surfaces like mouse, keyboard, desktop, laptop, bathroom surfaces, elevator knobs, door handles, staircase holdings. And then once you touch this, and then either you rub your eyes, you prick your nose, and you put something into your mouth without washing your hands, you'll get coronavirus. This is very simple. Everybody knows about this. But what can you do to prevent this is, first, if you come across any sick person, stay away from them at least 6 feet. You know how to calculate 6 feet? You remember the one arm distance that you used to have, you used to get taught at the school back home? And that's the only way to separate, to form a line between boys to boys is one arm, between boys to girls is 1 mile. That's a different problem to talk about later. But anyways, if you can calculate 6 feet, one arm distance, 3 times the one arm distance. Remember that. You need to maintain 3 times the one arm distance to prevent the spread. Second, if at all you are so tired and if you want to remove your glasses and then try to rub your eyes, make sure that you wash your hands before that. Sometimes people have this tendency to prick their nose because they don't know what else to do. Don't do that. And number three is, before putting anything into your mouth, wash your hands. When I say wash your hands, it doesn't mean like this for like 2 seconds. It shouldn't be like Rishabh Pant innings in T20, 6-6 and out. It should be like Rahul Dravid in Test cricket, slowly, every finger, back and forth, back of the wrist, front of the wrist, 2 fingers. To a point that the coronavirus itself will be so frustrated that it will leave your body and go to a different place. Like, you remember the Shoaib Akhtar bowling to Rahul Dravid in Test cricket? Shoaib Akhtar will go as far as he can. He will run as fast as he could and he will throw the ball like a bullet. What does our Rahul Dravid does? Took. And the ball dies down right there. Shoaib Akhtar gets so disappointed that he runs to Pakistan the next ball. Exactly similar to that, you have to spend at least 20 seconds washing your hands to prevent this virus. So when I say 20 seconds, CDC recommends to sing Happy Birthday song for 2 times. Or you could also sing your favorite song like, why this cola very, cola very, cola very dee. And then you could do 3 times to meet the 20 seconds. Okay, you could just be different. Hand sanitizers are better than nothing, but it is not effective. And if you want to use it, make sure that it is more than 60%, and then don't bring the hand sanitizer from the office. You know, you buy your own. Okay, you can order it Amazon. And other things you can do is, don't be an idiot. When I mean my idiot is internet derived information obstructing treatment. That is the syndrome that is bothering all the doctors everywhere in the world. And we are just sick and tired of this. All right. The only website that you should know is cdc.gov. Again, I repeat, cdc.gov, G-O-V. You don't have to do anything else. And you could also do like some general measures to improve your immunity. For example, get 7 hours of sleep. If you can't sleep at home, sleep at work. But make sure that you get 7 hours of sleep. Number two, get 150 minutes of physical activity, which will boil down to 30 minutes of physical activity every day. You know, you have to exert yourself. You know, if you see somebody lifting weights in the gym, you'll be like going near them and telling them that, Thambi, paathu, meduva, dumbbellukku valikke podu. Vegama thookuda, you need to increase your heart rate. You just cannot be like, hava, hava, hey, hava. Nothing will happen. You should increase your heart rate, at least to a point that you will exert a little bit. And then number third, foods rich in vitamin C, like citrus fruits, lemon, grapefruit, orange, has been shown to decrease the severity of the infection. And few other questions that I have been asked is, how about travel? So strict no-no if you're going to South Korea, Hong Kong, China, Iran, and Italy. And these are all like red flags in CDC website. If you want to go to India, make sure that you don't go through Hong Kong. I know it's very tempting to book the cheapest $500 ticket through Cathay Pacific. If you get that ticket, you'll get on the plane, but you might not go to India. All right, how about mask? If you are sick, please wear it. If you're not sick, please don't wear it. It is not of any use. And again, people who are sick, please wear the damn mask. Nobody is going to be appreciative of your beauty risking the coronavirus. All right. Don't be that waiter at home in that coffee shop where he puts all the five fingers at the same time, dipping into the five tea glasses, picks all the five tea glasses, keeps it at the center of the table and walks as if he's a hero. And we'll be like, wow, what a man. Don't be that person. Just be responsible so that you don't spread this infection across. And lastly, very importantly, don't be racist. You know, one of my patients this morning is asking me, should I have to avoid Chinese food? I was so mad. I was like, you know, go and log into your Facebook and block all your Chinese friends as well, because corona can transmit through Facebook. So anyways, be responsible, be safe out there. Treatment and vaccination, we don't have it here now. Gilead Pharmaceuticals is preparing this drug, which is in phase 3 trial, which is very good compared to the last few virus epidemics that we had. We are already in phase 3. Maybe in 3 to 4 months, we might get the virus, we might get the treatment. And vaccination, it's going to be only in July of 2021, maybe like 14, 15 months from now. So that is not going to help us right now. At that time, there will be another Corona 2. There'll be like Bahubali 2, and then hashtag will be like, who killed Corona 1? Like, who killed Kattappa? All right, guys, I think I'm done with all the questions. If you have any more, please let me know. I'll be happy to answer if I know. If not, I will seek the answer for you and then I'll get back to you. This is my first attempt in doing something like this at a stretch. So please ignore the fillers. And then we will try to come up with a different video next time. All right. Bye-bye.